Dear learners, welcome to Certificate in Arabic Language online lectures. I am Dr. Muhammad Salim, Assistant Professor, Arabic School of Foreign Languages, Indira Gandhi National Open University. Dear learners, in these lectures, you are learning some of the most exciting expressions that you use in everyday life situations. And I am giving you, I have selected some of the most, you know, frequently used Arabic expressions so that you can use it in your daily life situations. So keeping in mind, I have made it very simple and I have not any selected some very difficult expressions at this stage. For me, in fact, learning language through communication, through practice and speaking with your friend, with your family, with your other persons really is one of the most important way of, you know, learning it, because that is how you learn. You learn by doing, you learn by speaking. Okay, the more you speak, the more you learn the language. Okay, so dear learners, I am going to start, and the first important expression that I am going to give now is kullu aam wa antum bi khair. Very important expression. Very important expression, okay? Kullu aam wa antum bi khair. Kullu aam wa antum bi khair. What does it mean? Kullu aam. What is aam? Aam. It is not aam. No. Ayn. Aam. Aam. Wa antum bi khair. Kullu aam wa antum bi khair. What does it mean? It means happy New Year. Happy New Year. كل عام وأنتم بخير. كل عام وأنتم بخير. What does it mean? This Happy New Year. Okay, when you wish everybody Naya Sal Mubarak Ho. Okay, you say that this Naya Sal Mubarak Ho. In Arabic you say كل عام كل عام وأنتم بخير. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Okay. So, dear learners, you have learned very important expression. Just use it, you know, every year. You wish your friend, your family members, your relatives, your near and dear ones with this expression, كل عام وأنتم بخير. أنتم بخير. It's like, you know, blessing. You know, you are saying you wish all the best for the person you are, you know, saying. You are meeting, okay? So كل عام وأنتم بخير. كل عام وأنتم بخير. Okay? I hope you have learned it. كل عام وأنتم بخير. Now I am going to move on the next one, which one is short. It's not that long, but equally important. Important you use on several occasions, and that is مبروك. 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 What does it mean? مبروك. مبروك means Congratulations. Mabruk. Mabruk. So, the word, some of you might have heard the word Baraka. Al Baraka. Not Baraka. 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 Barakat. In Hindi, Urdu, Baraka. Baraka. What is Baraka? Baraka. Something. Some blessing. Okay. Something that is bestowed by, you know, God to you. Okay. Something that is adding to your existing thing. Okay, baraka, baraka, baraka. And mabruk, mabruk means congratulation, means barakallahu fik. It's like you are wishing the person for more. Okay, more. So it's a beautiful way of, you know, expression, expressing the of congratulation, you know, of extending the congratulation to the person who is with you. Okay, mabruk. So always remember this one, mabruk. 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 Just single word but conveying this meaning, you know. Mabruk is for congratulation. Okay, so now I am moving to the next one, and next expression in this line, okay, another which is very frequently used, and you need it, in fact. All these expressions that I'm giving you, you need it every time, you know. So, again, once more, another expression once again, Hafalu Zafaf. 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 Zahid. What is this Hafal? Hafal is occasion, a kind of, you know, a celebration. Zafaf. Zahid. What is this? Hafal Zafaf. Zahid. Zahid. Zahid is for, you know, happiness. Saada is happiness. From that, Zahid. Okay? So, happy. Happy wedding. Happy wedding. If you wish somebody happy wedding, okay, some person who has got married and they are together and you are going there, meeting them and want to wish them in Arabic. So this way you will say, Hafalu Zafaf Sa'id. Hafalu Zafaf Sa'id. This way you will say to them, okay. So say it several times. Hafalu Zafaf Sa'id. Hafalu Zafaf Sa'id. Zafaf Sa'id. A little bit long sentence, but very important, very, very important one. Okay, so dear learners, please remember this whenever next time you go to wish someone, okay, Arab person, of course, not any other you know, European person who is not speaking Arabic language, of course, somebody who is speaking Arabic language, and you got the opportunity, you know, invitation to attend the marriage ceremony. So the best way to go and congratulate them, and you will say mabrook, or half, then after hafalu zafaf sa'id, hafalu zafaf sa'id. So just memorize this one and use it, okay. And even if there is no marriage, nothing is happening, for your learning you can just practice it with your friend, okay, no issue. All right, now dear learners, we are moving to the next expression, and that is mahul jadid. It's like a question, you know, sometimes somebody breaks news, sometimes some people say anything, you know, repeatedly. That is boring, you are not interested in listening, in fact listening to all those, you know, boring stuff. So sometimes you say mahul jadid, what is new, okay, mahul jadid, what is jadid? Al jadid is new. Ma means what? Hua, it is just, you know, to add, it's like a conjunction, you know, ma hua, it just comes. Mal jadid, it's okay, but ma hua al jadid is a better expression, you know, a standard one. Ma hua al jadid, alright, ma hua al jadid. Al jadid, opposite is al qadim means old, al jadid means new, okay. Many of you are familiar with al qadim, al jadid, okay, al jadid, al qadim. So here, ma hua al jadid, what is new, okay. Sometimes even in fact you meet somebody, you just after kayf al hal, how are you, and ma sa turid, and ma, all that, then you start with this expression, what is new, ma hu al jadid, okay, ma hu al jadid. You meet some old friend or some persons who after a long time, you know, that then also you can use this expression, ma hu al jadid, means what is the new that is happening in your life, you know, for the or what the addition, or somebody who is scholar or scientist or researcher, okay, ma hu al jadid, what the new that you are doing, in fact, okay, what the, so ma hu al jadid is a, you know, very, you know, common sentence and frequently used, you know, expression. It will surely give you enough, you know, opportunity to communicate with somebody. Ma hu al jadid, ma hu al jadid, okay, a very nice expression, ma hu al jadid. And now coming next is la shay jadid, means if somebody is doing nothing, in fact, or is not willing to tell you, okay, or not interested in sharing with you all that is new that is happening in his or her life, okay, or nothing is happening there, everything is as it was, okay, there is nothing new. So the person will say La shay jadid. There is nothing new. It's routine. It's as usual. Everything is going on as usual. There is nothing new. La shay jadid. Nothing new. The person will say la shay jadid. So you have learned two important expressions here. Ma hu al jadid, one, and reply la shay jadid. And if in case there is something good happening, some new thing that is there in his or her life, okay, I'm sure he or she will share with you, and then you will get your reply for the question Mahul Didi, okay? So they will certainly tell you about their achievements, okay? All that they have got. Okay, dear learners, so this way, I hope you are learning it. These expressions, very common expressions, simple and easy to learn. All these expressions will certainly help you not only learn Arabic language, but enjoy each and every expression. All right. Now, moving to the next one, I am going to give you another one, and that is ana afam. It is very simple, you know. It's very simple. And all these expressions, don't think they are related to each other. These are common expressions, you know. The idea is to give you as many expressions as possible so that you can use in your communicative, okay, situations, and without any issue, without any problem. So now, next, and these are very frequently used expressions, okay. That's why I am focusing on them more and more. Ana afham. It means, what does it mean, ana afham? It means I understand. Ana afham. I understand, okay. And the next one is ana la afham. I don't understand. So two expressions you have got: ana afham, I understand; ana la afham, I don't understand. Ana afham, ana la afham. Ana afham, ana la afham. I understand, I don't understand. Okay. So this way, you know, it's very easy to remember, easy to use for you. Okay. Ana afham, ana la afham. I understand, I don't understand. Okay. So both way you can say, if somebody is explaining something to you, you can say ana afham. If you're not able to understand, okay, all that is being explained to you, then you can say ana la afham. Okay. Ana asif, I'm sorry, ana la afham. Ana asif, la afham. Okay, I'm sorry, I don't understand. Okay, this way you can use all these expressions and enjoy. Okay. Now, the next expression in this line is, it's very frequently used and you need it, all right? Because if you go to the market, you will certainly, you want to know the price of everything because so many attractive things are there. You may like to buy, purchase all these things, but can you purchase? You cannot everything, but at least you can ask the price, isn't it? It is easy to at least ask the price and then move away, okay? Don't buy everything because markets are expensive these days. But still, at least, okay, if you want to ask in Arabic, how much is this? Okay, you saw anything, you went to the mall, you went to the shop and you wanted to purchase something, just wanted to know the price of the thing, you are saying in Arabic, bekam hada. You see, very simple, very small, it's not any loaded. Bekam hada is very simple. Come, kitna, kitne ka hai bhai, hai na, puchte na, iska daam kitna hai, iski qeemat kitni hai, okay, is tarah se aap kehte hain. So bekam hada, how much is this, how much, bekam, price, you are asking the price, okay, qeemat, price, what is the price in Arabic, qeemat, so qeemat, you are asking for qeemat, okay, qeemat, the price. قيمته هذا من كم هذا من قيمته هذا okay come means how much okay and the next one is أراك فيما بعد okay some people they are not able to purchase because they don't have purchasing power they just want to inquire about the thing and then they move on okay so then you can say أراك فيما بعد okay see you later okay I am not interested in purchasing this item see you later Just promise the person that will come back when you have the money and you will purchase it, okay? So, araka fi ma ba'du, see you later on, okay? Later on, in the next visit, I will come to you, okay? Or this may be just general expression for you. Anybody, you are not interested, you know, you have just met it, met the person and you want to meet the person again, so you can say see you later. Or if the person is, you know, leaving you and you want him to meet you again, so you can use this expression araka fima ba'du, means see you later. Or it's a very general or common kind of the expression that people use nowadays, you know, see you later, araka fima ba'du. But if the person happens to female, again araki fima ba'du. This is Arabic, okay? And araka fima ba'du, if you keep kaf silent, so it's for both, you know. But in communication, that is not any way, it's not as much important to be, you know, but at least here ka ki, it's okay to stick to that. So araka fima ba'du for male, araki fima ba'du for female, okay? So dear learners, you are on the very exciting journey of learning the Arabic language, and now I am moving to the next expression, and it is equally important and very frequently used Arabic expression. So I am giving you hal. Now it starts with hal. What is hal? Hal, you have learned this in the earlier lectures and in the previous course that you have done. Hal, mata, kaifa, all these interrogative words. So here hal, it starts with hal. Hal, it means there is question, okay? So hal bi imkani, hal bi imkani musa'adatka, hal bi imkani musa'adatka, hal bi imkani musa'adatka, okay? Bi hal, can I help you, okay? Can I help you? And see the Arabic one, hal bi imkani musa'adatka. مساعدتك. Okay, so this way, if you want to help somebody, facilitate someone in certain things, you can start with this expression and you can say هل بإمكاني مساعدتك, هل بإمكاني مساعدتك, هل بإمكاني مساعدتك. Okay, can I help you? Okay, this is the. So I hope you have learned this, okay? I am repeating, you know, deliberately so that you can master it. هل بإمكاني مساعدتك. The person may say, reply you back. You say نعم أو لا, okay? If he or she wants your help, they will say نعم ساعدني, or simple they will say لا, means no, I don't need the help, thank you, shukran. Okay, this way they can reply back, but I am not mentioning it here. I am just it's for the sake of explaining to you, I am saying this هل بإمكاني مساعدتك, and the person may reply with نعم أو لا, okay, or and without using any other thing, simple no or yes, okay, لا, نعم or لا, okay. Now coming to the next expression, اعتمد على نفسك. Very important. اعتمد على نفسك. What is اعتماد? Many of you Urdu knowing persons, اعتماد, what is اعتماد? Trust, you know, اعتماد. So اعتمد على نفسك, اعتمد على نفسك, what does it mean اعتمد على نفسك? Rely on yourself, rely on yourself. اعتمد على نفسك, اعتمد على نفسك, rely on yourself. Okay, it's very important expression these days. We should always encourage people to rely on themselves instead of relying on everybody. Okay, so اعتماد على النفس, okay, reliance on yourself, confidence. Okay, it shows the confidence and your ability to, you know, to face the situation. So اعتمد على نفسك, rely on yourself, rely on yourself. Okay, so just remember this one. Okay, اعتمد على نفسك. So here also for learning Arabic lessons, اعتمد على نفسك, rely on yourself, because you will not get so many teachers always helping you and do this, all these expressions, all these, you know, recorded lectures will help you a lot. And الاعتماد على نفسك means your trust in your ability, your reliance on yourself. You have to rely on yourself. No other person will help you. Except if you are lucky, you will find a person, a colleague, a friend who can in fact speak with you or share. Or you have got an Arabic environment where you can speak the language and practice it. That will be your, you know, if you are lucky. Otherwise, these lectures will certainly help you. Alright, moving to the next, dear learners, I am going to help you, you know, more. You can practice all that, again, keeping the same trend as in the mind. As in earlier lectures you have seen, I have just helped you practice. So I'm not mentioning English, just Arabic one, and you yourself will, okay, try to recall the meaning, okay? So I'm going to give you next, Mabruk, Mabruk, practice one, Mabruk, 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 okay? What is Mabruk? I have explained to you. I will not any explain again, okay? Mabruk, you say several times. You say to the people you meet, Mabruk, 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 okay? Alf Mabruk, okay? So Mabruk, Mabruk, you are learning, all right? Mabruk. تعلمون اللغة العربية مبروك مبروك okay. ما هو الجديد and the expression ما هو الجديد الجديد you know القديم you know ما هو الجديد ما هو القديم okay. So all the expressions I think you are able to memorize. I need not repeat it again. مبروك. After that ما هو الجديد and next one أنا أفهم أنا أفهم أنا أفهم and next one أنا لا أفهم. Can you see some difference between the two? Ana afham, ana la afham. Ana afham, ana la afham. Okay? And the next is question. Hal tafham? Hal tafham. Okay? Hal tafham. Do you understand? Hal tafham. Okay? Hal tafham. Or hal tafham ma'qul. You see, sentence is getting longer. I have just added ma'qul so that I can explain it to you because it is important. Hal tafham ma'qul. Do you understand what I am saying or what I say? Do you understand? Okay. So this way, this is Arabic expression. Hal tafhamu ma aqul? Hal tafhamu ma aqul? And the answer is naham. Naham is yes. Ana afham. I understand. Ana afham. I understand. Or la. Ana la afham. No, I don't understand. I don't understand. Ana la afham. Ana la afham. Okay. Now, the next I am added one, Surirtu bilaqa'ika or liqa'iki, according to, okay, male, female, okay. Surirtu bilaqa'ika, this expression, I am happy to meet you. You have learned this one, I have just, you know, deliberately put it here to check your progress, okay. Surirtu bilaqa'ika, okay. Now, next one, araka fi ma'ba'adu, araka fi ma'ba'adu, araka, I will see you later, see, what is this? See you later, araka fi ma'ba'adu, araka. Or araki fima ba'd. Next one is i'tamid ala nafsika. I have just discussed this one, so I will not explain it again. I'tamid ala nafsika. I'tamid ala nafsika. And the next one is shukran, which is shukran. Okay. So dear learners, now I am coming to the next level and of practice. And here I will, you know, give you some English simple English expressions or sentences. You have to get the Arabic one, okay? I will not help here. You have to go back to the beginning of the lecture so that you can understand. If you are not able to understand, if you are able to understand, if you are getting it, then well and good and congratulations. Mabruk, mabruk, okay? So I am starting it. I understand. I understand. You say the Arabic one. You say the Arabic one. I am saying English. I understand. I understand. Okay. Then next one. Do you understand? Do you understand? Do you understand? And next one is what is new? What is new? What is new? What is new? Okay. This one I helped you practice so a lot, you know, in the early. What is new? I am happy to meet you. I am happy to meet you. I am happy to meet you. See you later. See you later. See you later. Right? See you later. Okay. Rely on yourself. Rely on yourself. Alright? This expression I have used several times and you know it. Okay. Next is Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. What is this Happy New Year? I have explained it to you. كل عام وأنتم بخير. I am saying it because it's very important. كل عام وأنتم بخير. And next one is happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. عيد ميلاد سعيد. This is new. Or if I can recall, okay, I have told you earlier, but here I am mentioning again. Happy birthday. Okay, عيد ميلاد سعيد. عيد ميلاد سعيد. All right. This is Arabic one. Okay. So, dear learners. Now, I am moving to the practice part 3rd, and here you will find same kind of, you know, Arabic expressions, and these Arabic expressions you will learn without much difficulty because I am giving you same thing in a different way, different fashion, okay, and helping you learn it. All right, so I will say Arabic version and you will say English one, or you repeat just Arabic one. Okay, you have to understand. I will not explain it. All right, I will just explain the pronunciation so that you become perfect in understanding the pronunciation. All right, so come on, let's do it. كل عام وأنتم بخير. كل عام here عين. كل عندنا كاف and قاف again. It's not قل. كل 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 عام عام. It is not عام. كل عام وأنتم بخير. كل عام وأنتم بخير. Good. كل عام وأنتم بخير. Okay. Okay. I'm not going to give you the meaning. You have to find it. كل عام وأنتم بخير. Now the next one is سررت بلقائك. سررت بلقائك. سررت بلقائك. لقاء. لقاء. What is لقاء? لقاء is. لقاء is. ملاقات. ملاقات ملنا ملن okay meeting. So سررت بلقائك. سررت أنا مسرور. You are familiar with this. أنا مسرور. I am happy. أنا مسرور. Okay. From مسرور سررت. سررت بلقائك. سررت بلقائك. Okay. Next one is أنا طالب ذكي. ذكي. This sentence you have learned earlier. Now I am repeating it and adding here. Okay. أنت طالب ذكي. أنت طالب ذكي. Can you understand it? Yes, you can. أنت طالب ذكي. ذكي. Okay. أنت, you are intelligent student. Okay. This means أنت. أنت. Okay. For female, أنت طالبة ذكية. أنت طالبة ذكية. For male, أنت طالب ذكي. All right. And next one is نجحت في الامتحان. For male, نجحت في الامتحان. For female. Okay. الامتحان. الامتحان. What is الامتحان? الامتحان is examination. All right. امتحان. You are very much familiar with. نجحت. نجحت. نجحت في الامتحان. Okay. Somebody is successful. So you are saying, okay, نجحت في الامتحان. And مبروك. 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 Congratulations. مبروك. 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 نجحت في الامتحان. مبروك. Okay. You say نجحت في الامتحان. مبروك. Or on this pattern, you can form many other, you know, expressions and sentences you can find. Next is أنت تحاول كثيرا. أنت تحاول كثيرا. أنت تحاول. ها. The pronunciation is not ها. This is not ها. It's ها. أنت. 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 أنت تحاول كثيرا. أنت تحاول كثيرا. Okay. Next one is هل بإمكاني. هل بإمكاني مساعدتك. هل بإمكاني مساعدتك. هل بإمكاني مساعدتك. Okay. I hope you are getting it. Okay. هل بإمكاني مساعدتك. Okay. Next one is سمعت. 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 I heard. Okay. I heard. سمعت أنك قد تزوجت. أنك قد تزوجت. This is new one. So I am giving the meaning. سمعت. I have heard أنك that you قد تزوجت. You have got married. Okay. I have heard that you have got married. This is okay. In Arabic. سمعت أنك قد تزوجت. قد تزوجت. Okay. And next one is, of course, the same. حفل زفاف سعيد. حفل زفاف سعيد. سعيد. Happy wedding. حفل زفاف سعيد. You are wishing the person. Okay. You have met just now. All right. And now the next one that is very familiar, quite familiar expression. مع السلامة. مع السلامة. مع السلامة. Or next, when you leave somebody, you say مع السلامة. So, dear learners, you have learned so many important expressions and very, very important expression that you can use in your ordinary life situations. And in that, when you leave somebody, you say ma'a salama means bye bye. When you say bye bye in Arabic, okay, you say ma'a salama, okay, or ila al-liqa means see you. Liqa is mulaqat. Qareeban means very soon. So ila al-liqa qareeban means liqa, but it is liqa and qareeban qaf. Okay, liqa qareeban, we will see you soon, means fir milenge. Okay, this type of expression is this, ila al-liqa qareeban. Okay, so ma'a salama and then ila al-liqa qareeban. So shukran jazeela, bye bye, see you in the next lecture.